Stop dancing. I want to talk about wine.
I'm having a seizure. It's not dancing.
That
please.
Is kind of what your dancing
call
looks like.
Call 911 right away.
And no, he hasn't had any of the it's, wine.
When old it's guy, just... old white guys dance, you know, the paramedics show up.
See, Terri and Ben are going to be very upset that they're not in studio. They're going to come in studio from now on. Terri Savaryn, from the owner of Savaryn Estate Wines of Waconia, and Ben Banks, the winemaker at Savaryn Estate Wines, are joining us on the line to just lighten things up and get us in the spirit of the holiday at this point. Hi, guys. Welcome to the show.
Hi. Greetings and season greetings from Savaryn Estate.
I love that. Hi, Ben.
Hi there. Thanks for having us.
I know you guys wanted to talk about sparkling wine. I happen to love champagne. I understand we can't call it champagne because it's not from the Champagne District in France. I get it. But you make a beautiful sparkling wine out at Savaryn Estates. Tell us about that, called Cameo Rose.
Yeah, it's something new that I've been working on. And, you know, one of the things that's neat about the, you mentioned the Champagne region of France, is it's the northernmost part of France's wine-growing region. So I thought Minnesota, being so far north, could be along the same lines. So I've been experimenting. This new wine, Cameo Rose, is a sparkling Sauva Blanc with Minnesota Frontenac, and done in a different style than the traditional French, where it's not going to be done in bottle, which kind of gives it that strong yeasty flavor or toasty flavor that I've noticed some people don't like in sparkling wines. Doing it in a different way, a small batch carbonic, and then manually filling and bottling gives a really lovely light fruit in the wine with a lot of crispness. It's been a big hit here.
Is it a rosé?
It is a rosé.
It is.
Frontenac is one of our grapes grown here in Minnesota that makes a lovely rosé, blended with a white wine to kind of give it a little bit more balance.
Nice.
But it's this really nice, light peachy pink that's very expressive with a lot of strawberry and raspberry notes, but then really light on your palate without any bitter aftertaste from the way that it's done.
So perfect if you're thinking about New Year's Eve or even down the road for Valentine's Day. Sounds very romantic.
Mm-hmm.
It's a perfect holiday wine. Mm.
Hey, Terri, can you tell us about the light show? I'm really intrigued with that, too. The notion that, Savaryn Estate can be a destination for your family. I mean, you can bring the kids down to enjoy the lights, and while you're down there, you can have a glass of mulled wine, which sounds wonderful.
The mulled wine has been a hit. The light show has been a hit. We are selling out evenings, so people are buying their tickets in advance, and we're expecting lots of people this weekend. The mulled wine, we take our red wine and mix it with some apple cider and some sliced oranges and that are studded with cloves and a cinnamon stick, and we warm it up. And it's wonderful use of our Marquette wine or our Sangiovese. Any red wine will do, but it's really nice to have a warm cup of wine to walk around and look at the beautiful lights.
I love that. So you need do you, does it need to be a special wine, like you said, the Sangiovese, to make it warm? And, I mean, warmer than just the room temperature that we normally drink our reds at, or a little bit chilled. Right.
You're going to warm that all up on a little, well, we keep ours in a little coffee dispenser, and just the tap is on all night. It just flows from one cup to
See,
the other.
I need that
but
in my house.
We serve it in like a coffee mug, and
then
they just, it's really good. It's a wonderful way to use the wine and keep you warm. And we're also making adult hot chocolates, which has been a big hit too.
Tell us more about those, Terri. What's in the hot chocolate for grown-ups?
Because we do catering and private events here, we have a full liquor license. So we're taking brandy, and Ben's been working with one of the local distilleries to make brandy, and we'll spike the hot chocolate for adults. And then they can pick any other variety of cordial that would be on a regular bar to add to the hot chocolate. So we like those, too.
Terri, do we have to go home afterwards? Can we sleep on your couch?
Yeah. Well, Santa's sleigh is available, and we do have our gingerbread house back in order. So there's a little sleeping loft in there. So if you need a place to stay,
perfect.
There's a little bit more room at the end.
And get more information online, SavarynEstateWine.com, and definitely worth checking out. Hey, thank you both, Terri and Ben, for spending some time with us today.
Thank you
for having us. We hope to see you out at the light show.
Absolutely.
We'll be back after the break.